In this webcast, we're going to look at the concept of base pairing. Base pairing is the way by which the molecular details by which information is stored in the nucleic acids, and it involves the concept of hydrogen bonding and hydrogen bonding in a complementary way. Long before the structure of DNA and RNA was known, it was known that whenever a sample was analyzed, there were equal amounts of the nucleobases G, guanine, and C, cytosine. So, for example, if a sample was analyzed and it contained 30% of G, there would be an equal molar amount of C. And if we have a total then of those two nucleobases equaling 60%, then we'd have to have 40% of A and T, and those two were also known to be present in equal molar amounts. So half of 40, we'd end up with 20% of A and 20% of T. That information had long been known, but the details of why those paired up in this way was something that had only been determined much later. And in fact, there's an interesting story about the tautomers and the misunderstanding of what was the predominant tautomeric form of the nucleobases that led people astray for a long time in trying to solve the structure of DNA and RNA. We talked about hydrogen bonding and that this is a strong, selective, and directional. And the reminder I want to instill with you here is that the hydrogen bond donor is the species that donates the hydrogen, and the acceptor is the species that has the electron pair to accept that. And so we have the N to sigma star interaction that is involved in hydrogen bonding. And the sigma star is the hydrogen bond donor. It's a little bit odd in that way, but we think about the hydrogen as being donated to the atom, which brings the extra electron density from the non-bonding lone pair. And if you look down here, one of the things we recognized was that nitrogen with a hydrogen bound to it, an N3 nitrogen, could serve as a hydrogen bond donor. A carbonyl group or another N2 nitrogen could serve as a hydrogen bond acceptor. All right, with that information in mind, then we can start thinking about the different tautomeric forms of the nucleobases. And here we have adenine in the forms that are shown here, the amino form and the imino form with an I. And so the two are distinguished according to what the tautomeric form is and whether this nitrogen is N3 or N2. And it turns out that the amino forms are the favored forms. We've talked about this once before when we talked about aromatic heterocycles, and it again has to do with this balance of aromaticity and resonance contributors. But the amino form is the predominant form, and likewise for the carbonyl groups that are present in the nucleobases, one could have the carbonyl form or the enol form, again where we've just changed this nitrogen from an N3 nitrogen to an N2 nitrogen and moved that hydrogen over. Now it turns out that it's the keto form that is the most favored form of these. And so you can likewise look at guanine also having a keto and enol form, the keto form being favored, and cytosine again having an amino and an imino form, with the amino form being favored. At that point now, knowing the correct tautomeric forms, we can look at and assign hydrogen bond donors with a D and hydrogen bond acceptors with an A. Let's go ahead and do that, and we can see that in this particular tautomeric form of adenine, we've got a donor and an acceptor, and that's going to end up matching complementary with the acceptor-donor interaction that is present in thymine. So AT pairing is going to involve donor, acceptor, acceptor, donor, and then there'll be an extra keto group that doesn't get involved in base pairing. And likewise, for the GC pair, we can identify in the tautomeric form that is most favored, ADD, and complement that to cytosine, DAA. And so again, there'll be ideal pairing. And now we can see those two AT and GC pairs in the complementary hydrogen bond donor and acceptor groups, with A having this deficiency of one group that isn't found, a donor that's missing, that's not really available or present in A that would match the hydrogen bond acceptor in thymine. Likewise, the GC pair has the perfect complementary match, and notice that those two are orthogonal. What I mean by that, notice that the AT pair wouldn't cross-reference or cross-pair with the GC, because we have ADA versus DAA, so there's a different information that's present in those, and that's what gives rise to the particular pairing. And so if you look on the bottom, you can see the molecular details of how those organize. The AT pair is going to have its hydrogen bonds between the carbonyl and the NHs, and the same thing with the GC matching the DAA ADD. Finally, let me just draw your attention to one thing. Look at where the N-glycosidic bond forms, and notice how there's almost a 90-degree angle between the two N-glycosidic bonds that come together, and you'll see that exact same orientation persists whether we're talking about GC or AT. And so from at least this geometry, steric sense, the two different types of base pairs would be completely compatible or interchangeable with one another. But wherever there's an A, there must be a T. Wherever there's a G, there must be a C. But geometrically, we could slide in any of those, either of those two pairs.